evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to St. Andrew's Church and today's presentation of Joyous Music. This particular event was started planning in 2017 in January. But the dream has been going on for a number of years longer than that. So we gathered together today an amazing group of musicians and singers and to help and celebrate and remember Duke City High School class of 1976. So we are gathered today with groups of people from as far away as Las Vegas, Eugene, Oregon, Washington State, the Bay Area. There's been a lot of people traveling a lot of ways to come here, all at the request of King Esper. The Center Performing Arts Association, along with collaboration with is proud to present Joyous Music.
Thank you.
God promotes this amazing by E.E. Cummings, which will be led by Ellen Lane Parrish, and throughout Homeward Bound by Barbara Knight, which will be read by the Reverend John Shearer. So now we'd like to bring to the stage our little stars, Dustin, Starla, and Valery Breshears. They are going to be performing, like I said, our little big shots with Steve Harvey pretty soon. If you'd like to come on up. Can I have a big round of applause?
Thank you.
auction area. Remember that word, silent auction, please? But there is a rendition out there of the plinth. It's going to be a large green monument in the lobby of the Sutter Theater. So we'll have the names engraved of all those that match. Please get pushed to put some money in that box. It's so empty. It really is. It needs your help. We really want to make this box fatter and stuff it full of it. So if you could. Also, the silent auction items are all donated as well. All of this money is going to be used to get the lobby together so that we can open the theater, which, believe it or not, is soon. We're really looking forward to having the last finishing pieces. What we're doing right now is basically making it look pretty, because all of this stuff that's underneath is done. Plumbing, electrical, fire suppression, those things that the city demands that we have done. So we're just getting it nice and pretty and ready for you, ladies and gentlemen. So if you can help us over this last little hump, and please help support the memorial for the Yuba City High Choir of 1976. Thank you.
Because the lid is facing the other way, so it's a little
Pastor Brooke has been teaching in our area since 1966. He started with the district, and he started teaching choir in 1970. When he was contacted about this event, he started sending out emails. And the result of all those emails and phone calls is sitting behind me. Professors and actresses, and they all have jobs and everything, but they did not hesitate to say, yes, we would love to participate with this. And during rehearsals, I talked to Dean, and he said this is possibly the best choir he's ever directed. So I would like to.
Bus crash happened, the people who came to help me out, I was all alone down there with and the person came to help. One of the first people that responded was a man named Zahn Burris, who's a firefighter down in that area. And he was there. He's here today. He doesn't want to stand up like that. But that's the kind of spirit that I want you to know about. Okay? So whether he gets up or not, I want you to give him a hand.
Thank you.
supporting the arts in our community. So can we have a big round of applause?
Anthony, Samantha, Smith. We're sending someone after them. I thought they were just running as part of the act, but I guess they're really in love. When they come out, let's give them a big round of applause. All right, maybe look. I would like to say, point out, I haven't mentioned her, Jan Roberts Hayden, our clouds. She did work for the dancers. We are going to, make sure we got back everybody home. Oh, this is the one. I've been waiting for this song all day. I don't know about you guys, but let there be peace on earth.
Better after death.
rehearsals to hear every time because it's the most beautiful thing I've ever heard. So please, the whole gang.
fantastic. Thank you so much for coming. You're a beautiful audience.
Before you go, I just want to bring up one person that we haven't talked about. Very common, she can come up. She has helped us arrange and put all this together here.
About 10 months of working on it, and I think it came out very well. I appreciate your attendance. We had volunteers, you know, we did posters and sold tickets and made cookies, like 50 dozen. And the silent auction committee and all their donors and the sponsors that are here today that sponsored the event, we owe them a huge thank you. Aika, I can't begin. Where are you? You're hiding. Come here. Come here. This lovely lady is a blessing, and she sort of wandered, well, not wandered, but happened to end up in our fair city and is absolutely doing a phenomenal job helping the Sutter Performing Arts and others to increase exposure to music and culture, and we appreciate it very much. I want to but most importantly, I have a couple of things I need to say, and I'm probably going to have to read it, okay, so forgive me. But we owe a huge debt of gratitude to Mr. Dean Estabrook. Gave not only his time, but shared his expertise and was willing to work with us, especially those of us who know nothing about music. And words are just almost useless at this point when I'm trying to say thanks to him. It has been a joy to work with you. I have loved getting to know you, and I have appreciated watching your face when you were working with these musicians in choral. They were amazing, the whole interaction, yes. So I need to say that though 29 voices were lost, no, they will not be forgotten as we move forward to honor a promise made 40 years ago to the victims, survivors, and families to provide our community with a performing arts center. And that's what the Sutter Performing Arts is about. So I thank you. We have a little token here for you. We hope this, yes, it's for you, sorry. Oh, he has his favorite scotch in it. Cookies in that other room, and I don't want to take them home. So please avail yourself, and thank you again.